On to the POGOS probe now. The Senate is up to investigating the Las Piñas incident involving the police and the supposed human rights trafficking activities associated with POGOS. Senator, how close are we now towards a position of totally banning POGOS given these developments?
We have been calling, you know, kami si Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, and I've been joining him in his call for the total closure of POGOS or to reverse our policy of allowing POGOS here in the Philippines, which in the hearings, PAGCOR admits that could easily be done, simply done, with instructions from the president, because they will implement the instruction of the president. So that's a very...
So are you saying there's even no need for a law for that?
Correct. Mm-hmm. That's a very good point that you raised, which I hope the president... Ito, one reason will... when I will applaud Stanley. Mm-hmm. If in the sauna, he will announce a reverse in policy that he will now be prohibiting or stopping POGO operations in the Philippines, we should be glad for that. And, okay, ito ililink... Ito sa peace and order, social harmony, problema na, peace and order. But let's link it also to water shortage, water consumption. Okay. Imagine, tayo-tayo na lang ang Pilipino. We already experienced water problems, water shortage. And now, tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of foreigners, we want them to be here in Metro Manila or in the Philippines to be additional burden to the public utilities, which cannot even serve us competently and conveniently, na tayo-tayo lang. So you see, that's an additional problem. Plus, of course, the law and order implication and the reputational damage. So that's a very good point that you raised, Stanley.
All right. Lastly, Senator Pimentel, yesterday we celebrated the 7th anniversary of our arbitral win in the case against China over disputes in the West Philippine Sea. Former Solicitor General Francis Hardelesa proposing filing another case before the Permanent Court of Arbitration. What are your thoughts on this?
He's the expert on this, but we should file another case if based on new grounds. Mm-hmm. Let us not relitigate what we already won. Yun lang yung concern lang naman ng mga concern ng iba kong nakakausap, that when we file something, then we are giving actually the other side a chance to bring up their planned original arguments, which they did not bring up because they boycotted the proceedings. So, and then if we get a negative result here, then although it may be on another matter, it can be spinned to mean that it is a reversal of the 2016 arbitral ruling. So if our position is that the 2016 arbitral ruling is already final and executory, so let us be careful in calling for a filing of anything which can be misconstrued or misinterpreted intentionally as a re-litigation of the issues which we have already won. So siguro the better course of action is really to pound on the 2016 arbitral ruling in our favor, Stanley. Hawak na natin yun eh. So let's pound on it. Let us be proud that the Philippines has played a role in the development, in enrichment of international maritime law. Tayo lang yata ang unang nagkaso nito na ganitong klase. So, and of course, this was studied by a lot of nations. This was studied by the arbitration court, the tribunal, so composed of many nationalities. So we can really say the Philippines contributed to the development of international maritime law. Pwede na natin ipagmayabang yun. And then number two, the practicalities of the decision.
Yeah.
Sabi ng decision that 9-dash line has no
basis.
Historic rights has no more has no application under UNCLOS. So all of these things, all of that, we should pound on that, ruling which is in our favor. Do not risk it anymore.
Okay. Lastly, we expect that as well to be covered in the President's State of the Nation address, the geopolitical tensions we have with China. Do you think this administration is on the right track as far as strategies and what it is doing about it right now is concerned?
No, I'm worried, Stanley. This administration is identifying itself too much in the camp of the United States. We're still in Asia. We're still in Asia. We will never leave Asia. Well, there are 10 million years from now, China would still be our neighbor. So we have to find a way to balance everything. Let us be neutral. Let us be maybe that slogan is good, a friend to all nations. But of course, we will stand up for Philippine interests. But we will not unnecessarily provoke any nation or any country, especially a giant neighbor. So, yeah. So that's what we do. We have to balance. Just an appeal to the Americans that let our relationship not be only or too much too concerned about the military or military preparedness, military transactions. The U.S. should help us with our economy, with our trade, with our goods. Help us. Teach us how you made your lands more productive. Share the secrets with us. So, ganun po sana. Let that be our relationship with the United States. Hindi po parati na lang na, warships will be sold to you, defense system will be sold to you. So let it be tractors, etc.
All right, we end it here, Senator Coco Pimentel. Thank you so much for joining us. Maayong buntag, amping kanunay.
Salamat, Stanley.